What's up guys, Alex here from FIFA Scouting Tips and welcome to part 3 of the FIFA 15 Scouting Guide. Now today I'm going to have a look at the best countries you can send your scout to, and by the end of this video I want to have answered 3 questions for you. Now, firstly, what are the best countries you can go away and scout? Secondly, do certain nations specialise in certain player types? So for example, do Italy have the best chance of producing good defenders, for example? And the third question is, does your scout get a boost from scouting in his home nation? So first of all, let's have a look at the best countries you can send your scouts to. Now if you've played FIFA 14 or read my FIFA 14 scouting guide, you may know that in FIFA 14 the different areas you could send your scout to were ranked, and if we have a look at the map here, the best place you could send your scout to in FIFA 14 was either Brazil or Argentina. They had the best chance of producing the really top platinum players. And then right down the other end we had Asia and Australia, New Zealand, and they had the lowest chance of producing these best players. So I wanted to know, is that still true in FIFA 15 or has it changed slightly? So what I decided to do was get two scouts of equal value, equal ability, both 5 stars experience and judgment, and send one to a top nation from FIFA 14 and one to a low ranked nation from FIFA 14 and see if they still produce very good and very bad players respectively. So first of all, I sent this scout here, the double 5-star scout, to Brazil. If I can get to it, there we go, to Brazil. And I sent him there for 6 months to get a good amount of players. And I sent him to look for any player type because I wasn't interested in how good he was at finding the certain type of player which I specified. I just wanted him to bring back, to see whether he would bring back good players. So I said any. As you can see, that would have cost me £204,000 for 6 months. Now the second scout I sent to one of the lowest ranked nations in FIFA 14, that was New Zealand. And again, 6 months, any player type. And that cost £34,000. That's a huge difference in cost. And you think just from looking at the cost that going to New Zealand would produce far inferior players than going to Brazil because of the massive price difference. Well, let's have a look and see if that was true. So I have the players which I scouted at the end of the scouting trip. And as I scroll through, if you look at the flags in the top right, you'll see they're more or less equally Brazil and New Zealand. And when I counted them up afterwards, I found out they were actually exactly the same. There are equal numbers of players from Brazil as there were from New Zealand. And I wasn't just taking any old players, I was taking players such as this one, where their potential range, for example 86 to 92, the top number would have been in the early 90s or late 80s, so they're all very good players. And as you can see, as we go through here, some of these players, you know, it's narrowed down a bit, not quite as good as they looked when I first scouted them, but there are an awful lot of very good players in there. Now the very best player I found was this one here. Overall 72 to 78, that's incredible. He was from Brazil, obviously. But I did find some other very good players from New Zealand. This one here, for example, 82 to 88 potential. And I did a little test and promoted these players, and the second best player was actually this one, this goalkeeper from New Zealand. So considering the differences in cost and supposed abilities of these different regions, to have an equal number of players from Brazil as and from New Zealand, that was pretty impressive, pretty unexpected really as well. And now I don't know if this is just a one-off or whether this is a bigger trend, so I'll be doing some more testing and I'll show you that later as well, but just from this initial one, it looks as though you might be able to save yourself some money and go to a cheaper region, and as long as you have a very good scout, you still got a good chance of bringing back top rated players. So that was a very interesting thing, and I wasn't sure if this was a one-off, like I said, or whether there was a bigger trend, so I did some more testing and I'll show you that now. Right, let's have a look at the second test I did, and here we have two very good scouts again. Slightly different scout this time in Austria, I had to reload a bit, but anyway. So I decided this time to send this guy to Argentina, again along with Brazil, one of the top rated countries in FIFA 14, and again 6 months, £204,000, and the second scout I decided to send to another one of the lowest ranked nations you could send your scouts to, and that is Saudi Arabia, 6 months, again £34,000. So let's have a look at the players that these scouts brought back after 6 months. So here we are in the academy, and I've gotten rid of any sort of players who didn't turn out to be quite as good as I thought, but we've still got lots of very good players left in here, and there are 8 in total, and 4 from Saudi Arabia and 4 from Argentina. So once again, taking 2 equally good scouts to one of the best countries you can go to, supposedly, and then one of the worst, and I got, again, an equal number of players from each nation coming through. And actually, if you look at it, the best players, the players with the highest potential, are actually from Saudi Arabia. So this one here, 83 to 89 potential. A couple of 82, 88 from Argentina, but then we get another 83 to 89 from Saudi Arabia. So it does seem as though scouting in different nations is less important than the quality of the scout you have. So, I mean, it may very well be that nations are ranked, or areas are ranked, on their likelihood of finding the top players, but in practice, you may not notice that as long as you have a very good scout. Now, one more thing just to talk about before we move on to the next topic, just a little thing I noticed. I did think, after doing lots of testing in FIFA 15, that they'd fixed the goalkeeper problem, where they would have multiple outfield positions, such as, you know, goalkeeper slash centre-back, which just seemed very weird. I did lots of testing, and I could only find goalkeepers in one position, until I found this guy from Saudi Arabia, goalkeeper slash right midfield. So it doesn't really affect how he plays or the game mechanics, but it's just a bit silly, and I thought I'd let you guys know. Now, just to clarify, I've put on screen now an image from the FIFA 14 scouting guide, and this was taken from the game code, and it shows a breakdown of the rankings of each different nation and their chances of finding platinum players, in other words, the best players that you can possibly scout. And it looks a bit confusing, so I'll just walk you through it. Basically, on the left-hand side, we have youth player platinum, then two numbers. One number, then an equal sign, then another. The first number is the code for each region, and then the number after the equal sign is the chance of that region finding the best players. So the higher the second number, the better chances they have of finding good players. So if we look on the right hand side, you can see what each of the first numbers means, or each code means. So for example, 0 is sub-region Argentina, Brazil. So it doesn't mean that's all of South America, that's just Argentina and Brazil. If you look back on the left hand side, we have 0 equals 15. So that basically means 15 is the highest number. So that means that Argentina and Brazil have the highest chance of finding platinum players. Now, if we look down on the left hand side near the bottom of the list, we have youth player platinum 10 equals 1. Then back on the right hand side, 10 means sub-region Australia. So that's Australia and New Zealand equals 1. So that's the lowest chance of finding good players. So you would think that in my first test, when I did Brazil and New Zealand, that Brazil would be running away with it, and they'd have way more top rated players, but that wasn't the case at all. As we know, I had equal players who are good from both region. So it seems to me like this, the career mode hasn't changed a huge amount from 14 to 15, so this may still actually be in the code. If anyone does know, could you please let me know? That would be awesome, because I haven't had a chance to look at it just yet. But from what I've done, my preliminary tests, it seems like it doesn't make a huge amount of difference. So I thought I'd post it out there just so you could see the actual rankings as it was last year and as it may well be this year as well. Okay, the next thing I wanted to look at was whether certain regions or nations specialised in producing certain types of players. And I've always maintained that they didn't in previous versions of FIFA, because I've done an absolute ton of scouting and I never ever noticed any sort of, any certain nations producing certain types of players more commonly than others. It always seemed to be that you could get any type of player really from any region. But when I produced the FIFA 14 scouting guide, it was pointed out to me that in the game code, actually, there were provisions for different regions producing or being more likely to produce different types of player. So for example, according to the game code, the area of Asia, so if we send a scout off, I'll show you what countries I'm talking about. Over here, China, Japan, Korea, and Saudi Arabia had the best chance of producing fast players. Now, I wanted to know whether this was true, so what I did was I sent off 3 very good scouts to 3 different regions, to Spain, Italy, and Cameroon, and I just told them to search for any player types, because I thought that this would, if different countries did specialise in different player types, this would come through when I search for any player types on my reports. So here are the players I found, and as you can see on the right hand side, there's quite a mixed bag, all sorts of different player types in there. And one thing which I found was interesting was that Spain and Italy, according to the game code, have the joint lowest chance, along with a couple of other nations, joint lowest chance of finding physically strong players. And yet, in both cases, the most common player type in both Italy and Spain that I found in these scouting trips, was physically strong. Similarly, if we look at the Argentina and Saudi Arabia scouting trip that I did earlier on, we can see that, again, it's a bit of a mixed bag. And Argentina supposedly is most likely to find wingers, technically gifted players, and attackers. And yet, that's not actually true because, well, it wasn't true in my experience because the most common type was this one, physically strong. I found three of them. I didn't find as many of the other player types. And Saudi Arabia, being in the Asia region in the game, we should expect to find lots of very good wingers. But as you can see here, there's not a single winger from either region, in fact, but not a single winger from Saudi Arabia, despite that supposedly being the one which it's most likely to find, or which it has the best chance out of any region of finding. So I think, while I haven't actually had a chance to have a look at the game code or had anyone else confirm that for me, but if it is still the case, I would be tempted to say that with normal scouting, you're probably not going to notice any certain patterns. If you did 1,000 scouting trips and you noted down the player types of every player that you found, you may notice a pattern coming out. But I think if you just do normal scouting on the normal level, you're probably not going to notice any player types being associated with any different regions, because I certainly didn't when I did my testing, and I've never noticed it ever since I've started playing FIFA, or ever since I started being able to scout on FIFA anyway. And so like I said, I think if you're looking for a certain player type, you may not get results if you send them to a certain region. It may not work like that, and you probably won't notice it on an everyday basis. Going back to the Spain, Italy, Cameroon scouting trip that I did, I also wanted to have a look at whether you get a boost from sending a scout to his home nation. So what I did was I sent off my three scouts, and I sent them to these countries, and I sent the Spanish scout to Spain, and then the other two scouts, one was Belgian and one was from the Czech Republic, and I sent them to Cameroon and Italy. Now, the highest potential player I found in here was this one, found by a Spanish scout going to his home country, and he has potential 88 to 94. But at the same time, the player with the highest overall range was this player down here, which my Czech scout found in Italy, which is obviously not going to his home nation. And if we have a look through all of these potentials, they're all very high potentials, very good overalls, and it seems to be that case regardless of whether they're going to their home country or not. So for example, we have another good one here from the Belgian scout going to Cameroon, 78 to 94 potential. That's extremely high. It hasn't narrowed down very much at the moment because I only just found him, but that is almost as high as you can get when you first scout a player. I think the highest I've ever seen is about 81 to 94, 80 to 94. So 78 to 94 is extremely high for the first potential range. So again, it seems as though something which used to be the case in previous versions of FIFA, in this case sending a scout to his home nation, doesn't seem to apply anymore. I know it didn't apply last year, or I certainly never noticed that it applied last year, and it doesn't seem that it applies this year either, because when you sent a scout to his home country, you used to get a little star appearing next to his name, which is an indication that he is likely to get better players. But again, it doesn't seem to have happened. So I hope that's cleared that one up for you. Okay, there is one more thing which I think is more important than where you choose to send your scout, and that is reloading your reports. Now, I will do a more in-depth video on this in the future. I just want to really quickly explain it and why I think it's more important than the nation you choose to send your scout to. So my scout is due to come back tomorrow on the 3rd. So I will just advance one day up to there, and then I will have a look at the report that he sends me. And what you can do is, if you don't like the players on your report, all you have to do is quit your save, load it up again from the day before your scout is due back, and then you've just got to advance one day to get the report, and your players will be different on the report. So let's see who we've got this time. We have 5 players in this report, and actually quite a lot of them are very good, but let's just say that I'm not very happy with this. You know, I'm a very picky manager. 75 to 94 potential isn't good enough for me, even though it's actually fantastic. So we quit that one, we go back, we quit the save, we load it back up again. And then when it comes up, you'll see I'm back on the 2nd, the day before my scout's due back. So we'll advance one more day again. We will then bring up the report, And if we have a look, we now have different players, different potentials, different names. We actually have six players this time, and the report is different. And so what this essentially means is that if you have, let's say, like I did before, you have a good scout, you send them to Saudi Arabia, and because Saudi Arabia isn't very highly ranked, let's say that you don't find any particularly good players, you could just quit your save, reload it again, advance to get the scouting report, and this time you might have better players. So that kind of makes it irrelevant where you send your scout, because if you reload your scouting reports, you can easily get good players from anywhere, essentially. It may take a little bit more reloading if you go to a worse nation, but as I found in my earlier tests in this video, you can still get fantastic players even in the lowest ranked nations. So it does seem to be that reloading is more important than that. So I think I'll wrap it up there for today, guys. Thank you for watching. If you did find this useful, please do leave a like below and leave a comment if you have any ideas on what you want me to do next time. And if you thought it was good as well. And cheers, I'll catch you next time.